I swear to Christ, you can't make this shit up. Do, 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 do. Do 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 do. Ladies and germs, I do declare that it is officially raining pennies from heaven, and I am a rolling in the Lincolns. Brian Stelter just got fired from his cushy job at CNN thanks to him constantly producing shit ratings on his TV show. And I, for one, want to simultaneously offer Brian Stelter the best of luck, as well as my sincerest condolences over the founding and ultimate failure of his YouTube channel as he tries to outshine Keith Olbermann.
They're afraid. 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 And most importantly, they are afraid.
On second thought, I think that's too big of a hill for you to climb, Brian. So I sincerely hope that you send me your resume, because I think I got a little venture that can benefit the both of us. Pimpin'. Pimping ain't easy, that goes without saying, but Brian Stelter gonna make it easy for this cat. Got me a street corner all decked out for him, prime piece of real estate, and I'm gonna make sure that slut puts the O back in the hoe. And if he don't, then I just might have to go and choke a bitch. Now, I gotta keep this on the DL, because hoeing out that bitch Stelter is guaranteed to make me an extra $10 to $20 a month. But if the IRS catches wind, then they could sick their hyper elite tactical squads on me, and because they're using my taxpayer dollars to fund these squads, they're gonna be sending the best of the best after me. You know who they are? You guessed it. 280-pound man children and cripples. It's pretty refreshing to know that all it took for the IRS to get over its crippling ableism was for me to pay them a fuckload of money. Now, I've been telling people for years that all federal agents need to be laid back and cool. Doesn't matter if they're armed with minimal firearms training. All that matters is that they are putting the dude back into due process.
What is this?
We're the IRS. You're under arrest. You're going to jail, buddy.
These guys are so bodacious, it's like if The Rock was an armed branch of the federal government. I gotta tell you, this is the American Communist Party's best idea ever. Just look how excited and mentally cognizant Joe Biden is over this whole thing. He's so happy that he had to slowly hand Chuck Schumer that pen. He looks just like a baby. A bumbling, stupid little pedophile baby with access to the nuclear codes. Hey, speaking of the downfall of civilization, the World Economic Forum has already come up with a way to combat the food shortages that haven't hit us yet. And the solution is so simple, you're not gonna believe it.
Feed a bug!
Absolutely. The world governments have already figured out a way to starve you into malnutrition with 1.5 million ways that you can eat a bug. Maggot butter, maggot mustard, maggot mayo, maggot milk, locust milk, centipede milk, cricket flour, spider sugar, scrambled wasps, crispy hornet chips, peanut butter earthworms. Probably more, who the fuck knows at this point. That menu reminds me of all of those ice-cold summer nights at Grandma's hobo camp. We used to sit around the tire fire and fill up on Grandmammy's firefly stew. Grammy always used to say, if it glowed in your belly, that meant it was working. But now we've got it way better. We don't gotta worry about the meat, because the billionaires took all of it. They're feasting on beef, chicken, pork, and other yummy proteins, so we don't have to. Who needs a porterhouse steak when Nicole Kidman, a washed-up has-been actress, is telling you that eating bugs is perfectly fine? And kinda sexy. Her claim to fame was getting railed by Tom Cruise. If that doesn't make her a meat expert, I don't know what the fuck does. But if you have to be a massive racist and have some meat, the good news is Bill Gates, a completely legitimate businessman and massive pedophile, has his own little cure in the form of laboratory-grown meat and breast milk products. It's a good thing that he invested money from
the Bill and Melinda Gates Institute for Population Control
to fund his totally legitimate and non-coincidental business venture. The truth is, we have no choice but to sacrifice every single one of our comforts, because if we don't, there is no possible way we're going to shorten our carbon footprint. It's simple math. Just don't do math. It's racisms, and if you do any kind of critical thinking whatsoever, it clearly means that you want the blacks back in chains and the yellow Chinese to rebuild our railroads. The sacrifices that we make benefit the children of our celebrities so they can fly around on private jets and enjoy lavish vacations while lecturing us about how we're horrible people for enjoying hot showers.
How dare you?
So if you're one of those capitalist cocksuckers out there who thinks it's dehumanizing and disgusting to eat bugs instead of regular food, then you're probably a militia violent extremist who deserves to spend time in the gulag. They'll put you hard to work harvesting bugs for Thanksgiving dinner. So get on your knees, Mr. and Mrs. American Patriot. You got some slugs to harvest for my holiday loaf. You're welcome.
What is up, Mahones? Arstan the Unclean here. Thanks a thousand for checking out the new video. If you think Nicole Kidman was a terrible marketing choice for 90% of most products, then hop on board the same train as we depart Crazy Town. Give some love to the like and subscribe button if you got the time, and the comment section is yours to do with as you please. Today's subject is discount sheetrock. It's times like this that I miss the 90s. Super Nintendo, Corn Pops, and video stores were all we needed for a good time, and it was so great that I didn't even mind paying the late fees. So be sure to be kind, rewind, and as always, thank you for caring, and I'll see you in the gulag.